Hey, it's Thomas here, and today we're doing a quick review on Brine Shrimp Direct's Brine Shrimp Hatchery Dish. If you're looking for an easy way to hatch brine shrimp without needing to power equipment like an air pump that automatically separates the baby brine from the cysts so that you can get those picky eaters like dragonettes or pipefish started, or even just treat all of your reef inhabitants to live planktonic food, then you'll want to check out this hatchery dish. I've used quite a few different hatchers over the years, and this one's my favorite. 10 out of 10. Feeding live planktonic foods is a great way to vary the diet of your reef inhabitants. It can also help encourage finicky eaters like dragonettes, pipefish, and seahorses to start feeding and provide nutrition to hard to feed baby fish, and ultimately is a welcome treat for just about everything in your tank. Baby brine shrimp, otherwise known as Artemia nauplii, have been a long-standing favorite live food of aquarists for a number of reasons. Most importantly, it is really easy to hatch brine shrimp. It takes very little effort, and the brine shrimp eggs themselves are relatively inexpensive and easy to store for long periods of time. The size of baby brine is also fantastic for a wide variety of planktonic feeders, from baby fish to corals, and it is really easy to gut load them for extra nutrition. Brine Shrimp Direct has one of the simplest, easiest, and least expensive hatcheries for regularly hatching baby brine to feed your tank. Easy enough that if you want baby brine on hand every day, it's a cakewalk. In the box, you'll find the hatchery dish, the white baffle system, the harvesting sieve, the brine shrimp egg scoop, and some easy instructions. The hatchery is simple, but really smart. It doesn't require an air pump or any other equipment, and uses an ingenious baffle system to automatically sort the live baby brine from the cysts, making collection and feeding a breeze. Like I mentioned, the instructions are really easy. Firstly though, you won't want to move the dish once you're hatching, so pick a room that's going to get some light and is around room temperature, which should be between 68 and 72 degrees. Next, mix some dechlorinated tap water or RODI water with aquarium salt or synthetic sea salt mix that you already have on hand for your water changes. Place the white baffle ring with the notches face down, fill the container with salt water to the fill line, use the included scoop to measure out the eggs. I'd personally recommend the BRS high yield brine shrimp eggs. The hatch rates on these are incredible. Then sprinkle the eggs around the outermost ring. Next, place the cover back on top in the closed position and insert the harvesting sieve into the center opening. Then after 36 to 48 hours, you should start seeing those baby brine shrimp right in the center opening over top of the sieve so you can harvest them. So what's actually happening on the inside is that the eggs on the outermost ring are blocked by the white baffles, but as the baby brine shrimp hatch, they're attracted to the light at the center opening and they navigate the baffle system towards the light, automatically separating themselves from the cysts so that you can easily harvest them without worrying about accidentally scooping up the empty cysts along with them. There are a number of ways that you can feed the baby brine shrimp to your inhabitants, including just using the sieve, lifting it out with some baby brine shrimp in it from the hatchery and then directly into your tank. You can also grab a cup of water from your tank, use the sieve to dump them into the cup, and then use a turkey baster or other feeding tool to target feed. Personally, I'd actually move the baby brine into a separate small container of salt water with some spirulina mixed in to gut load them. After a few hours of swimming in the spirulina-rich salt water, they should be full of the green stuff and extra nutritious. Now, if your goal is to grow out the baby brine to feed some larger inhabitants, you won't be able to do it very easily in the hatcher, so a simple 5 or 10 gallon tank with a sponge filter will be your best bet. Moving all of the baby brine into a separate tank also gives you the opportunity to rinse off the hatcher and start the next batch so you always have live brine shrimp on hand. At 25 bucks, this is really a great tool to have on hand to add some variation to the diet of your reef inhabitants or even feed some picky feeders, especially because you don't need an air pump, which, you know, hums or could potentially siphon. This is just easy, breezy, beautiful live baby brine. You may not want to personally feed live food forever and aim to eventually get your live feeding fish over to prepared foods. There are lots of different options for foods to try, frozen food probably being one of the most obvious when you're trying to convert a live feeder over to prepared foods. Ryan and Randy actually have a video outlining all of the best fish foods for 2019, and you can check it out right here. Lots of different options there. Some are even both fish and coral food simultaneously, and I didn't actually expect that in that kind of form factor. It's pretty neat. Check it out.